Hey, it's Rob. Welcome back to Axel's Garage. Yeah, well, we did it again. And those of you that are paying attention know that we had a Pearl. Pearl was a white Yukon Denali. I think it was maybe an 03, 04, 05, something in that range. But we had Pearl for a while. We did a bunch of videos on it. I'll put a picture of Pearl in right here. And we were enjoying Pearl. Pearl was running great. Had some issues with Pearl with the brakes. You can watch through the videos that we did on Pearl and really had our buttoned up looking good. The problem with Pearl is, not being a Yukon XL, was that even though all the kids are out of the house and we're empty nesters, it was still too small. We tend to load vehicles up with stuff all the time. My wife was using Pearl. She really liked it, but it was just too small in the back. Didn't have enough cargo room. Keeping the back two seats up, you know, without folding them. So you still had a back seat and we wanted some cargo room. So we replaced Pearl, and if you've been paying attention, a friend of mine, Frank, bought Pearl and he loves it. Oscar here, we got one more video for Oscar. Oscar is gonna be going up for sale soon, so if you're interested in Oscar, drop me an email. But the only video we have left, we've been using Oscar like a truck, and Oscar runs great. Been using Oscar back and forth to work quite frequently. Runs great, great on fuel, being a V6. It's the what's that noise? We did a video on a strange noise in Oscar. We discovered what it was. That will probably be Oscar's final video, and that's coming up soon as well. But in the meantime, I woke up, I go to work at night. So I woke up, took a shower, got dressed, came down the stairs over the summer, and coming down the stairs behind me is the little big dummy with this like weird grin on his face. And I go into the kitchen to get my coffee so that I can leave to go to work, and my wife's got a funny grin on her face. I go, what are you guys looking at me? Oh, nothing. Nothing. And then I see the little big dummy. He's sort of like in the kitchen, but half out of the kitchen, like doesn't want to come face to face with me, and he's got this stupid grin on his face. Couldn't figure out what was going on until I'm about to walk out the door and grab my keys, and I'm grabbing Oscar's keys, and my wife hands me a different set of keys. She hands me a set of Chevy keys, and I go, what is this? She goes, oh, this is what you're driving to work. And I'm like, what are you talking about? Just go outside. So she gives me the keys, I go outside. There's a vehicle sitting outside that apparently was bought for me by the big, big dummy Mark over at Axles East. No story, no nothing. All I know is there it sat. I drove it to work. Didn't even know whether there were plates on it or not at that point, but there were. And I'm gonna show you what it is. So for your viewing pleasure, I introduce to you our next project vehicle at Axles Garage, Barry White.
My first, my last, my everything, and the answer to all my dreams.
So I'm back here standing next to Barry White just to show you how large Barry White is. Way over my head. And Barry White's had some stuff done to him over the years. So Barry's sporting an HD hood, a lift kit. It's just big. So it's a 2005 Chevy Suburban Z71. I don't even know how many miles Barry has on him, but Barry's in nice shape on the outside and on the inside. It's got a nice gray leather interior. It's got rear buckets. I'm kind of digging Barry, especially once I cleaned him up a little, gave him a good wash. I liked it. However, Barry does look a little high in the front end. And just, you know, a little quick overview that I went over Barry was that the front end measured from the fender lip to the middle of the hub about 25 and a quarter inches, and the back 25 inches even. I don't know if that measurement is gonna calculate to how level Barry looks. Barry actually sits level if you measure it along a couple points along the body. However, it looks up in the front, which I don't like that look. So we'll have to do a little playing around with Barry. I did drive Barry for a couple days while we had the tags from the previous owner on it, and it was making a little noise. Threw in four-wheel drive just to make sure everything worked, and it was making a little bit of noise in four-wheel drive. So I went from auto to four low just to see if it all worked, and I made a turn while I was in four-wheel drive, and I clunked one of the front CV shafts right out of it. So it just ripped out completely. It's still bolted up on the transfer case side. It's still bolted up through the hub, just at both CV joints in that axle shaft. It just chunked it right out the bottom of the truck. So we got that to address. There's no belt on the AC compressor, so we got that to address, and a couple other little glitchy things here or there, which we'll be making videos on. But this is Barry. It looks like it's got a 3-inch lift kit in it based on the spring spacers in the back. It's got spacers, it's got coils, and it's got Bilstein shocks up front. It's got Bilstein shocks, but what I did notice, and I found in the folder of receipts that I got with Barry here, was that they put aftermarket keys in. I don't know what brand keys they are, but there's an instruction sheet for the keys, and when I looked under, they seemed to be cranked up pretty high, and when I looked behind the wheel, it looks like the upper control arm is bottomed out against the bump stop, which means they're cranked way too up. So hopefully we'll be able to lower it just a little bit, make it look nice, and have a good gap between the upper control arm and the bump stop, so it's not riding on that bump stop giving you the harsh ride. But this is Barry, and Barry is not really replacing Pearl. We don't know what we're doing with Barry yet, but we're going to do some work. We're going to make Barry look good, drive good, function good, get everything working on Barry, and then we'll decide Barry's future. We'll decide his future. We'll see how it goes. I was never a big fan of like an all-white truck. A little too white for me. The grill, the fender flares, the bumpers, I don't know, we'll see. We'll see how it turns out in the end. We'll see, maybe we'll play around with some stuff, who knows. But that's it from Axel's Garage. The addiction continues with another project vehicle, Barry White.